cracked open another beer to sort of celebrate the glamour of starting a new lifestyle, and began to play. And I was trying to remember what he had said. I was playing. I was tight, and I would fold. And they were, and the players. It's true. Just like Kirk had said, the players were very aggressive. They bet and all the time, and every they were just all the time. It's like they always had these hands betting, and I was losing very quickly. And I noticed after a little while, about an hour and a half of this, one of the players I was losing the most to was this maniac who was in almost every hand all the time betting. His screen name was M Brown 714. I started to realize, you know, the sun was coming up and I was maybe not thinking so clearly, but I thought, you know what? I know this son of a bitch. I know who this is. M. Brown, 714 from Huntington Beach. This is Matt Brown. This was my nemesis. Matt Brown, my nemesis in eighth grade, back in junior high school, seventh grade, eighth grade. The kid more than any other who was responsible for making my then life a then living hell. This had to be him. He was always so aggressive and we would play. We'd play basketball at recess. And you know, and then there was nothing. It was just, could you play basketball? How assertive were you on the court? That was the sole way that a man defined himself. And Matt was, he was very aggressive and he could beat me. And finally, Matt, because he was so aggressive, continued to foul me. Now that I was shooting a lot, he was fouling me and hacking me and all these things, and I got to take a lot of free throws. But he didn't realize that you shouldn't really foul someone ever who cannot make any shot except a free throw. And I noticed that the way he looked at me began to change. Like the way he regarded me, and his sort of a little bit of a hint of respect was blooming there. And after a game one day, he came up to me and he patted me on the shoulder, which is the first time he had ever touched me in a non-violent way. And he said, you know, we should hang out sometime. And I said, come back to my mom's house after school and we'll have a wonderful time. And we did. We went back and we played Super Mario Brothers. And at a certain point, Matt got up and said, you know, where's the bathroom? We were having fun. And I pointed out I had my bathroom, which is the bathroom that I was charged with cleaning. It was a Dixie cup on the floor because over the summer there had been a cockroach in the bathroom when I had been taking a shower, and I panicked and I put the cup on top. So this moment when Matt said, I heard him from the bathroom, he flushed, he opened the door, he cried out, what's this? And I was walked over there to say, oh, don't worry about that, but it was too late. He was picking it up, and I shrieked. I let out a scream because I'm very scared of it, screamed, and Matt shot me this look, and I knew immediately that the story, I screamed, frankly, like a little girl, and the story, I knew the next day all around the schoolyard, it was going to be this story that the roach and the Dixie cup, and he would be telling it to everybody, and as soon as I realized what was about to happen, the trap I had set for myself, I started to cry. But now I thought, 15 years later, the sun's coming up in Brooklyn, and I have Matt Brown by the short and hairies because he's being way too aggressive. He doesn't know how to play. He's betting all the time. He's like a maniac on a Gallagher machine. I was going to win all the pots right then. I knew it. There was no doubt in my mind. And as I was about to, and he was betting, and I was betting, and I knew he was betting. He was a sucker, and I was going to get him. And as we were about to just have the showdown of all the hands at the very same time with just me and Matt and all four of these pots, this beast, it was almost the size of a duckling, frankly, this enormous roach darted out from underneath the desk, and I went after it across the room, killed it dead without no hesitation and no Dixie cups. And I whirled around to the computer monitor, ready for a moment of double victory, and I saw that I had been automatically folded out of all four hands. But Matt Brown got no comeuppance that evening, and if he ever thinks of me these days, I'm sure he remembers that moment and the scream like a little girl in the corner of the bathroom. But that cockroach can tell you, I kill like a man. Thank you.
Amazing.